All of the questions from today's live mailbag come to us from our live shows, right? If you want to be on the mailbag, then you got to subscribe. We're getting closer and closer to 250K. Hit that big red button and subscribe right now. From Burn and Spade, shout out, y'all. No question. Just wanted to say from my family to all dads, happy Father's Day. And to all the dads in the chat sports family, thank you so much, Burn and Spades. I'll let James and Brett know, since they are dads, and I'll be joining that group in November, so thank you very much. From Ultradick Grady, will Zach Wilson win Rookie of the Year? Good question. He'll be in the discussion. I think one of the quarterbacks end up winning. That's typically how things end up going, at least more often than not, because it's the sexy position. I don't know in the end if he will. Maybe it's Justin Fields, or maybe it's Trevor Lawrence, the betting favorite. If he starts all 16 games, that's win like even just 7 games, then yeah, I think Zach Wilson does. From Liam Gaming 622, should the 49ers trade for a receiver? I actually don't know if they need one that much. Obviously, like, remember, George Kittle, guys, is the number one receiver. He is incredibly impactful for that team. Brandon Ayuk, Deebo Samuel, I am hyped there. I don't love Mohamed Sanu, but maybe Jalen Hurd, maybe Juwan Jennings, maybe one of those guys impress. If they aren't, then yes, I would look at the trade market around roster cutdown time. Right this second, though, let's see what the young guys can do. From Thomas Angel, first off, great first name. What playoff team last year will fall out this season? I am worried about Pittsburgh in the AFC. If Big Ben is second half of last season, Big Ben, things are going to get dicey there. I don't trust Carson Wentz for the Colts. In the AFC, if Aaron Rodgers is not in Green Bay, they're not going to make it. But the team that jumps out the most to me, the Saints. If it's Taysom Hill, I don't think so. They'll be above or around 500 football team. I'm not sold on New Orleans this year. From All Day, Every Day, name a player the Chiefs should trade for. Again, I think you're looking defense more so than receiver for Kansas City. Now, the big name corners, of course, are Stephon Gilmore and Xavien Howard. Those names certainly make sense. Beyond that, though, you're probably going to use Chris Jones more at edge rusher. Okay? It's a little weird there. I think Zach Ertz makes no sense for them. I would be looking secondary. And if Howard and Gilmore are a bit too expensive, hey, maybe J.C. Jackson's not that expensive. Maybe that's a move that could make sense for KC. Now, I think this answer here will be Chiefs heavy. But who do you think will end up winning the Super Bowl this year? Get your votes in on today's pinned comment. If you get the ad break here on YouTube, scroll on down and let me know. From King J, should the Cowboys trade for Xavien Howard and Brandon Graham? I doubt Philadelphia moves Brandon Graham right now. They just redid his deal. They save like no money. So probably not an option there. Xavien Howard, had they not drafted two corners in round one, or in the first 100 picks, then yes, but they did. So unless they want to include Kelvin Joseph, which could maybe work, I don't think so. Plus, they don't ever pay corners. Howard wants big-time money. It would have to be a departure in the typical MO from the Cowboys front office. If the Patriots are looking to improve, which position slash player should they be looking at? Well, you got to take quarterback off the market. Not going to happen. They always spend a first-round pick on Mac Jones anyway. I think the defense this year, with the COVID opt-outs back, is going to be a lot better. So, as we've said for years now, isn't it receiver? Like, yeah, they added Kendrick Bourne and Nelson Agholor. If they could get a legitimate number one receiver to pair with the two tight ends that they're going to run a lot this year, that would be a big addition for the Patriots. What receivers do you think could be traded this offseason? I think in general, we're kind of at the end of the notable players who are going to get dealt outside of a couple, you know, more roster cutdown type of moves. The big names, Odell Beckham, I don't think he's going to get moved at any time in the near future. I don't think Michael Gallup gets moved by the Cowboys. if teams start to struggle, the Jets redid Jamison Crowder's deal, so I guess that takes him off the list. There will be some deadline or some trade deadline deals for a receiver. Hopefully not as bad as the Mohamed Sanu trade for the Patriots. But if things get disastrous in Green Bay, just keep an eye out for Devontae Adams, maybe. And I guess Allen Robinson if things go bad for the Bears, too. All right, from Daniel Sharp, trade package for Seattle for Xavien Howard. I mean, look, you don't have a first-round pick, so that makes it difficult. So it's probably got to be a second-round pick and one of your young corners. I don't know if Trey Flowers moves the needle at all. Maybe DJ Reed does. Maybe Akello Witherspoon. It's not a great offer since you just signed Witherspoon. I think a second-round pick is all Seattle will be able to lead with outside of moving one of their big-time players, which doesn't make much sense because they're trying to win games right now. Let's talk defense now. Who will have the best defense in 2021? Get your votes in for me in the comments section. I think Pittsburgh's going to be great again. Washington, Tampa, if they're healthy, the 49ers. And yes, Sam, the Denver Broncos as well. Let me know what you guys think in the comments section. From Big Dog 2047, fantasy question. Would you trade Stephon Diggs and T.Y. Hilton for D.K. Metcalf and Jarvis Landry? First, is this PPR? If it is PPR, I feel a little bit better about getting Metcalf and Landry in that deal. If it's Dynasty, kind of a wash there. I don't know how much T.Y. Hilton has left there. If it's a Dynasty, which makes sense since you're already asking me about it, if you're contending, I think I lean toward keeping Diggs in standard. Otherwise, PPR, give me the Landry side. From Cody, more receiving yards, Julio or A.J. Brown? Good question. I will go full coward here and hedge my bet. With the injuries being a potential concern, I'll go A.J. Brown over Julio Jones. From Chill Will, any free agent edge rushers that KC can sign? Yes, there are. I think Melvin Ingram makes a lot of sense for that defensive scheme. I think he'd be a good addition for KC if they want to go with what I call a journeyman brief addition. Justin Houston, depending on how sides are going there, makes some sense. If Olivier Vernon's healthy, I like him. Everson Griffin. There are some older but potentially impactful edge rushers out there for KC. From Rosendo IDK, do you think the Broncos will trade for Deshaun Watson? I don't know. There's some major off-the-field stuff with Deshaun Watson. I think right now he's pretty much untouchable. Like, I don't think that really carries any value. Like, that's a major problem. So if it gets cleared off and situated and everything's all good, then maybe. Until then, it's way too hard to know. From Michael Kerr, can the Broncos package Royce Freeman, Cam Fleming, or Cushenberry and lock in picks for Rodgers and go get Mitchell Schwartz? So Royce Freeman, Cam Fleming, no value. Like, those are not valuable players for Green Bay. Like, Freeman would be at best RB3 for them. Cam Fleming could maybe be a swing. So you're offering Cushenberry, lock, and picks. If there are multiple first-round picks, then maybe. Now, Green Bay drafted a center. That impacts them as it relates to Lloyd Cushenberry. Might make it a little bit less appealing there. Locke helps a little bit, but those picks are going to be pretty low in round one. If there is a bidding war for Drew Locke, for Aaron Rodgers, I might have to bump the value there in terms of what you give up if you're Denver. You guys can get this T-shirt and hat combo pack right there on your screen by going to the link at the bottom, chatsports.com/NFL combo. All 32 teams, they're on sale, limited time only. Normally $50, right now under $30, $29.99. So go check it out, chatsports.com/NFL combo. That link will be in the comments section and in the description to make your lives easier. So go check it out right now. From Mark Mulo, which team still signs Richard Sherman? If not, does he retire? So my prediction at the beginning of the offseason was the New York Jets. Obviously need a cornerback. Robert Saleh is their new head coach. The connection is there. The need is there. It makes sense. I'm still going to go there. and make that my prediction, because Sherman wants to wait. Sounds like there's a situation where there's a weird, he wants to play for a contender and wants to wait and hasn't been much interest. Maybe he settles in the end and does end up going to the Jets. From You Got Cheese, Gilmore for like Amari Cooper or Allen Robinson. The Cowboys would probably say no because A, they've paid Amari Cooper, and B, Cooper is substantially younger than Stephon Gilmore, and age matters in these types of trades. Now, had the Cowboys not gotten to the draft yet, might have made a little more sense there. The Bears one's a little bit more intriguing. And if I were Chicago, A, I would simply pay Allen Robinson like a normal franchise would. If they're not going to, I think Gilmore is about as good as they could possibly do. So, less so for Cooper. If the Bears aren't going to keep A-Rob, that one does intrigue me at least a little bit. From Carne Asada, does Mahomes still win the division if Aaron Rodgers goes to the Denver Broncos? Maybe. If we get 2020 Aaron Rodgers on that Denver Broncos team, depending on what they go, if it's a similar roster, similar construction, it might be Denver. Like, that Denver team is missing a quarterback. That's what they need. They got a great defense, good young supporting cast. So it becomes a fascinating battle and might be a true coin toss in the end. Let me know what you guys think to this question now. Who is the most underrated NFL team in 2021? You can be nice in the comment section. And yes, pick your favorite team as well. Most underrated team in 2021. Let me know what you guys think. From Elio, if you're Bill Belichick, who would you start? Cam Newton or Mac Jones? If Mac Jones is ready, and he is ready to take over as a starter, knowing he's going to learn on the job, give me Mac Jones. And I'm not as low on Cam Newton as others are. He was fine before the COVID and then was terrible after it. If Newton is head and shoulders better than Mac Jones, then of course you keep him. If it's close, which I think it might be, give the reins over to Mac Jones. After all, he is your future, not Cam Newton. From Lil Eden, can you see Myles Garrett getting Defensive Player of the Year? Yes, he can. If he can get to 18-ish sacks this year, which I think is always a good threshold for that type of award, then he's going to be in the conversation. He is one of the best defensive players in the NFL. So, yes, he will very much be in that conversation. Kyle Daugherty, should the Steelers trade for Chase Winovich? If they can get him cheap, yes. I think he'd be a great number three edge behind Alex Highsmith and TJ Watt. I don't think, however, the Patriots are going to bail so quickly on Chase Winovich. So if he ends up being affordable, so like a fifth-round pick, I'm all for it. If it's more than that, which I think it is right now, the answer is no. From Tiki Tacky Tiki, who's the Broncos' best defensive player of the year candidate? Bradley Chubb, Von Miller, or Justin Simmons? Acknowledging that defensive player of the year is in part a popularity award, it's probably the biggest name on that list, Von Miller. If all three guys play to the best of their ability, it is Von Miller. Although at the stage of his career, not sure that's the case. So get your votes in. Great job building this quickly, by the way, producer Jeremy. Defensive MVP. Who is it? For Denver, at least. Type BC for Bradley Chubb, VM for Von Miller, or type in JS for Justin Simmons. Get your votes in for me in the comments section. Michael Kerr, all jokes aside, Arizona Cardinals, most underrated, they get no talk. It's a good answer. I think that's a very real possibility as it relates to the Arizona Cardinals. Gary Sanderson, your worst NFL draft takes ever. I mean, first off, where do we even begin? I had a take, Josh Allen was going to be a top five quarterback out of the NFL within 3 or 4 years. I'll be right on that front. I thought it was going to be out of the NFL, though. So, Josh Allen, big L on my part. Guys that I liked who are not good, Hakeem Butler, just a massive L for me. Like, he has never been anything good in the NFL. I loved Tease Tabor coming out. Huge mistake on my front. That was just a disastrous goal there. Other players I'm looking at my boards from years past I was super high on. I feel like Maurice Hurst, I'm blaming on the medical condition, but he hasn't been that great. Let's see. I had Lamar Jackson graded the exact same as Sam Darnold. So I'm claiming victory on Lamar Jackson on that front there. I like Taven Bryan a lot. He has not been particularly good. I also loved Montrevis Adams, the Packers defensive lineman. He was never good. A huge L on my part. I was pretty high on Billy Price, top 45 player. I like Jimmy Clausen too. Oops. I had Malik Jefferson and Billy Price in my top 50. Two just disastrous ones right there. There's a very long list of, well, that was a bad grade on my part.